the king of old school, Steve Corino, the former ECW World Heavyweight Champion. And I've seen a lot of extreme stuff in my time. I've seen people fall off balconies. I've seen people go through millions of tables. But until I stepped into the Canadian Wrestling Federation, it made ECW look like child's play. This is where the extreme action is. This is where the hardcore action is. This is where all the insanity is. If you want all that hardcore action, the blood, the barbed wire, tables, chairs, you come to one place, and that's the Canadian Wrestling Federation, sanctioned by the National Wrestling Alliance. Who better than to give you the world than the king of old school himself, Steve Corino? Go out and buy a ticket. Watch it on TV, because the CWF is the best wrestling going today. You're gonna get the beating of your life. And Swan, you stick your nose in my business, you're gonna find out why they call me the Big Kahuna, the man that makes them and he breaks them.
Curtis Young Bear looks mean tonight. Take a look at him standing in the corner there. He's stretching it out.
He's got his war paint on.
He's ready for Big Kahuna tonight.
Well, he wants a piece of the Kahuna. He wants to take him down.
Guys, we got a problem. We have a problem.
I don't know if
It looks like the Kahuna suffered an injury.
He comes out on crutches. What's going on here?
I think maybe I should take a pump.
I think I smell something.
Perhaps he fell backstage.
I think I smell another cover-up by the Kahuna. Some more BS.
Curtis Young Bear doesn't know what to make of this. And if I was Curtis Young Bear,
Don't take any pity on him, Young Bear. Lay him out. Lay out the Kahuna. He needs a good slap.
You guys, think about this. Big Kahuna just finished off a match with three guys. You know if he was ready to wrestle, he'd come out and he'd wrestle. There must be a problem.
I was upstairs stretching out and getting ready, and I got attacked by two guys in long coats wearing masks, and I didn't know who they were, but they smelled like Gene Swan and his buddy, the Hunter. That's what they smelled like. Now, there's no way the doctors examined me upstairs, and there's no way that I can wrestle. I tore some ligaments in my knee when they shoved me down the stairs from behind. And there's no way I can wrestle. As much as I would like to get in here and teach you some respect, there's no way I can do it. The doctors will not allow it. So I'm going to have to pass on this one. I'm sorry to disappoint all the fans, but there's no way that I can wrestle in my condition. I'm sorry, there's no way. I'm sorry, Kenny, here, take the microphone. I'm sorry. I apologize.
Trust this man.
That was a sincere shot with a cane. The crutch. Now he's choking him with what's left of it here.
Turn your back on him.
Curtis Young Bear.
He's a dirty snake in the grass.
And the snake just bit him.
Young Bear's paying for it.
gotta use his head.
Tapping.
Wait a second. Out of the back. Hunter.
Here he goes, the Hunter.
Now, this isn't fair, you guys. Take a look at this.
Oh, I look good. Turning his tail once again with that phony limp. Just a second ago, we see him use that limp miraculously, as you said, Randy, to hit the man with a crutch.
Tucking his tail and turning back.
Well, you guys look like the two guys that attacked me upstairs. I'd like to get in there and teach you a lesson, but my knee is beyond damage. I can't do it. Shut the hell up, you! I can't see that word in here. We're on TV. There's no. You want a piece of me, Swan? I'll give you a piece of me. You want some of me? Yeah. Okay, I'll come. You want a piece of me? Yeah. Okay, come on. Okay, get back. Get back. I gotta get in the ring. Get back. Get back.
Hey, well, hold that hold, Shane Rogers. Somebody hold. Come on.
Get back. Get back. I'll get in there. Get back.
Afraid of the dark? You should be.
So Big Kahuna felt he couldn't continue on in the match, you guys. Madman decided to take over for him.
That limp making his way to ringside here.
You guys, let me get out of the way here for the Big Kahuna.
Out.
Watch those derogatory remarks there, Kahuna. How's the leg, eh?
I got some serious damage to my knee. I just mustered up enough strength to get in there and make that young bum tap out.
Please tell us another one.
That was a miraculous comeback there for a second. We saw you run across the ring and nail Curtis Young Bear with that.
Well, the adrenaline was flowing. And, you know, I didn't want to disappoint the fans, but, you know, another 30-0. What am I, 30-0 now? 29-0?
Thanks to some help. Match. Thanks to some help.
Gene Swan, he's the one that attacked me in the dressing room. Him and that other Hunter guy is his bodyguard. They attacked me in the dressing room.
They
pushed me down the stairs. I damaged my knee. I don't know what else. I'm such an honest person. I tell the truth all the time. Why would I make a lie up like that? Why?
Where did Madman come from? He came out of the crowd, I think. He's got the upper hand right from the outset.
Well, Madman Martin told me, he said, Kahuna, I know you got a problem with Gene Swan. You need some help. I'm there for you. So actually, we're taking a serious look at bringing him in as another member of Team Impact.
Another hired gun.
But tonight, he's got to prove himself here in the ring.
He's proving the Gene Swan right now, what the Madman is all about. This is what that big clothesline spear.
That's an illegal move. That should be outlawed. The referee should take charge.
Tomahawk.
That move should not be allowed in wrestling.
High impact move by Gene Swan.
High impact shots raining down across the forehead. Madman.
Madman looking worse for the wear now. Gene Swan on top of him.
Well, you know, I'm glad to be back at the commentary table again here. I was upstairs warming up all for a good hour for that match, but like I say, somebody attacked me from behind with long coats on. I swear to God, it was Gene Swan and the Hunter. It smelt like them because they never wear deodorant. I don't think they buy deodorant because they're too cheap. So it smelt like them. So it had to be Gene Swan and the Hunter because nobody else has such a foul smell like that, except for maybe assisted suicide.
And Dalton.
The Madman driving his knee into the groin area.
Attaboy, Madman. Do your job.
plays to the crowd. He should stay on top of Tomahawk, otherwise he's going to get tomahawked. So is the Cartel alive and well?
Well, that Team Impact is alive and well, that's for sure. Team Impact is oh, what a... Did you see that?
That was a smooth
move. That was a kick to the throat. A kick to the throat by Gene Swan. Did you see that?
That was a select move.
That was a kick to the throat by Gene Swan.
A great move pulled up by one of the unbelievable veterans of Canadian wrestling. Gene Swan at any time to take out anyone here in Canada.
Gene Swan, Madman Martin going at. Come on, Madman Martin.
Nails him with a big right hand. Irish whip. Reversal. Oh,
big clothesline by the Madman.
That was a mad clothesline.
He took his head off.
Right on the mark.
And I totally agree with that that particular move.
Who couldn't agree with that move? Driving that elbow into his neck. Across the chest and neck area.
Madman coming
in. It might be
now.
As red as his hair. He had to rip the shirt off.
He looks like a little bit like the Red Rooster. Remember the old Red Rooster in the WWF? That's what this guy reminds me of. You know what? I saw a bit of red hair going through that mask when that guy attacked me. It had to be Gene Swan. Had to be. Attacked me from behind like the coward that he is.
Choking Tomahawk Gene Swan right now.
Unbelievable. Attacked me from behind like the coward he is. Attacked me from behind like the coward he is.
There are no cowards here in the CWF.
Gene Swan taking his lumps now from the Madman.
Madman had to jump in the back there. Here we go.
Gene's throwing some shots to the midsection.
Big Irish whip.
Oh, right on the spine. My God.
That ring didn't
right
have any give
spine.
On that one. Rattle his kidneys.
Right on the spine. I don't know. Maybe I got to go for x-rays here on my knee. It's done. There's a lot of pain here right now, but I'll tough it out.
Yeah, I'm sure.
I'll tough it out here. For all the fans out there in the APTN land, I will tough it out because you know what? The Big Kahuna, there's nobody that calls color like the Big Kahuna in wrestling today. Madman Martin putting the boots.
He's putting on a colorful beating.
Madman all over Gene Swan.
Madman using that leather strap to choke Tomahawk Gene Swan right now.
An illegal move, of course, but
stretching him over that top rope.
Lax rules are the way of the CWF.
Just about took his throat out. Just about took it as Adam's apple.
His larynx.
Tomahawk took his Adam's apple out.
He's out
his Adam's
feet.
Apple. What are you doing now, you big? His Adam's apple just about to take it out.
He'd be lucky to talk after this.
Over the rope, nobody home. Smart ring savvy on behalf of Tomahawk.
That was a savvy move by Gene Swan. He was in trouble there, and he pulled himself out of the ring just in time.
Whether it was savvy or just instincts, our man, he pulled himself out of the way.
Combination of the both.
Gene Swan, does it look like he's busted open there? What's that?
That could be his war paint.
I think his hair dye is running out in his face.
Actually, he does look like he's split open here.
Gene Swan will lay it all out on the line.
Well, you know, last night at Brandon,
every event he's a part of.
We had a big Fans Bring the Weapons Battle Royal that was actually barred from Brandon. The Brandon police came out there and told me we can't run that match anymore.
Was there barbed wire around the ring?
Barbed wire Bunkhouse Battle Royal. It has been barred from Brandon. We can't run that match anymore.
Just too extreme, too severe. It's wrestling just
too down.
So actually that cut in his head could have been reopened up from last night.
I've seen a lot of the wrestlers here tonight. They all look like they could sport bruises or cuts.
It's
that must have been a heck of a show last night.
It's quite possible. It's quite possible.
Roll through.
It was one of the most extreme wrestling shows. Well, you know what? I got to go to the washroom. Right back.
Oh, what about your sore leg? Where the hell are you going?
Once again, the Kahuna leaving the commentator's booth. Again. I just wonder. I wonder
he's
what's up here.
With that bell, our man.
I wonder what's going to happen now.
Sore
some more dirty, underhanded moves pulled off by the Kahuna.
He's at ringside for no good reason at all.
I think we need a little production here.
Dunlop's bleeding from that cut on his forehead, our man. That's not paint.
That's his own blood dripping down his face.
How much more does he have?
He was out in Brandon last night.
There he is, arguing with the Kahuna. Madman's making his way in behind again.
Uh-oh, Gene Swan's got the Kahuna. Gene Swan.
Madman's got that ring bell. Setting up on that second rope.
The Madman looking for Gene Swan off the rope. Drills him in the head with the bell.
The production's out of here. Madman nailing him with that.
Gene Swan seeing stars. The Madman setting him up now. He's got him. He's got him hooked.
Double underhook. Wait, when he changes his mind, driving his face to the mat. I seen that sort of.
And that's it. The Madman Martin.
Hunter out of the back.
Look out, folks! It's the Hunter. And he wants a piece of the Madman.
The Hunter coming in at the last minute to save Gene Swan from. What happened there?
I seen you limping your way to the ring there.
I had to go to the washroom.
That must have been a heck of a sore leg.
Once again, you can't.
I had to go to the washroom.
Well, be alone.
15-pound ring belt you're carrying. It must have helped your leg a little bit.
I had to go to the washroom.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, tonight, yours truly, Showtime Robbie Royce, the Canadian icon, the CWF heavyweight champion, takes on Steve Corino. That's right, the man, the mouth, the legend in his own mind is here tonight to face me. Tonight, I am going to show this guy 16 years he hasn't been around. I am going to ruin his homecoming. Steve, I got news for you. You may be the NWA North American champion, but tonight you are going to go down as the shortest reigning North American champion, because I am going to show you why I am the Canadian icon, the feature presentation, and I am the only show worth watching.
Remember, kids, we're trained professionals. Don't try this at home.
We're in for a treat here, fellas. Steve Corino makes his way to the ring.
The moment Winnipeg has been waiting for 16 years.
There he is. He's wrestled in sold-out houses all across North America.
The king of old school.
And there he is. Welcome home, Steve Garrido, NWA heavyweight title holder.
The fans love him. There's not going to be much of a warm welcome tonight, as Robbie Royce shows him why he is Showtime. Welcome back to Winnipeg, Steve, but he's not going to be too happy.
He makes his way around the ring area, saying hello to all the great fans here tonight. Fan favorite, obviously, right off the bat.
Fans just waiting for this match to get underway.
Like I always say, you know a good wrestler when he has his name on his tights. The only problem here tonight is both wrestlers have their names on their tights. But I'm going to go with Showtime.
Showtime Robbie Royce. if those guys are going to have any involvement in this match. And there's the music.
There's the music.
As if on cue.
And there's the smell. You smell that?
And do you see he's not limping on that supposedly sore knee of his?
Yeah, he's kind of missing that limp now, ain't he?
He got quick. He's a quick healer. He may have been hurt before, but he's probably okay now. You got to lay off the big kahuna. Just remember, you guys, if it wasn't for him, you wouldn't have a job.
Kahuna's got something to say here right now. Let's take a listen.
Showtime, good luck. Wait 1 minute here, Steve. Since I know the fans want to see what a hell of a match they're going to see it tonight, but since you were the former ECW heavyweight champion, what I'm going to do here right now for you, because I like you, is I'm going to make this match ECW rules. That means there's no disqualification, no
contest. Big Kahuna is a very fair man. Look at that.
Very fair, very smart man, I think.
That's what I'm going to do for you tonight, Steve, because I like you. So what you're saying is, if I take Robbie into the 15th row, that's all right. That's right. If I take Robbie outside to the parking lot, that's all right. That's right. If I throw Robbie off the balcony onto his big fat head, that's all right. That's perfectly all right.
Great shirt Big Kahuna's wearing tonight. That's a nice shirt. I like that stuff.
This is the Canadian Crime Spree Spider. Some people say I'm too violent. Some people say I'm too extreme. Well, too bad.
Nobody does it better. That's not a shirt.
Big Kahuna's coming over here. I'm going to make some room for the boss. You guys.
See you later, production. Collar and elbow hook up in the middle of the ring. Robbie Royce pushing Carino to the corner. Couldn't help but notice you weren't limping as much there, Kahuna.
Well, I got some quick cortisone shot by the doctor, and I seem to be a little better right now, which is more than I can say for Curtis Youngberry. They took him off to the hospital. He's got a little bit of damage to one of his knees. I don't know how he got it. He must have fell down the stairs or something, but I came in giving the fans what they want. ECW rules. Former ECW heavyweight champion Steve Carino against the Showtime Robbie Royce.
Why would you make it ECW rules? That's putting the ball in Steve Carino's court.
Well, I'm trying to make it as comfortable as possible for him here. I know he's out of respect for him. I made this match ECW rules.
Nobody does it better than Royce playing to the crowd here, asking for approval. Getting it from some and not from others.
And this is for the NWA North American title.
As we were saying earlier, this is history in the makings. An NWA title being put up against the CWF title.
Well, that's right. Both titles are on the line here tonight. Steve Carino could very well walk away with our titles.
Nobody wants to see that.
Nobody wants to see that.
Stretches him in the ropes. We're going to see a clean break. No!
Slapping in the face.
A total lack of respect for the CWF champion.
Well, you know, like I said, anything goes here, so the fans ask for it. I give it to them because I give the Big Kahuna The Big Kahuna gives the fans exactly what they like, exactly what they want. Extreme wrestling, only in the CWF.
I don't think Robbie Royce much appreciated that slap to the face by Steve Corino. He's not going to appreciate too much once Steve Corino gets through with him tonight. Both men a little tentative here. They don't know what to make of each other, I think. Collar and elbow, right in the square middle of the ring. Reno powers Royce to the corner. And this time,
going downstairs and slapping him there.
Royce thought he was being crafty, and there's the strut.
He's getting a little too cocky in the ring there. He doesn't know what he's in for with Showtime Robbie Royce. I don't know if you guys were here last time, and he saw him put Paul Diamond through two tables off that balcony and become the new CWF Heavyweight Champion.
But that's not Paul Diamond in the ring right now. That's Steve Corino.
Oh, that's right. And only the Big Kahuna can bring you in, the top talent into Manitoba. Only can bring you the top talent to the APTN viewing audience. If you want to book us, you give us a call. We'll bring you all the stars of the CWF. And we can bring you all the hottest talent here available in the independent circuit.
I didn't want to disrespect Paul Diamond by saying a comment like that, but he got taken to the limit last show here.
Well, that's right. And, you know, Showtime Robbie Royce, he's a now wrestler. Paul Diamond was a wrestler of the past. Sure, he's got a lot of great credentials. But hey, he couldn't even beat the Machine.
The Machine was on top of his game tonight.
He's the number one competitor, and one of these two men is going to have to face him. Task in its own. Power of that headlock. Royce cinching it back on.
The Corino is never cocky there, Kahuna. He's only confident.
Well, Steve Corino, he's a very popular wrestler all around the world. From here, he's going on Wednesday down to Tampa, Florida to go for the NWA World title against Mike Rapata, the current holder of the title.
Whoa! Duck under by Royce. Irish whip reversal. Telegraphs that boot, then clotheslines him to the mat. Misses with the elbow, fast moves by Royce. Corino rolls out of the way. Whoa, both men are throwing it at each other. Quick pin, one count. Quick pin again by Royce. Corino kicks out.
What a pace we have here, folks. What a wrestling match we got here. These two competitors are, Robbie Royce has proven that he's evenly matched with Steve Corino. Right here in the CWF.
These two men just threw everything they had at each other. Corino acknowledging Royce with a applause, I guess.
And neither competitor backing off an inch.
They can't afford to back off an inch. When you give an inch, they'll take a mile.
Neither competitor willing to give an edge here. Looks like, you know, even though I ordered an ECW rule so far, we've seen a nice clean match. Just like the Big Kahuna does.
We've heard that one before.
That was a clean shot to the back of Curtis Youngbear with that crutch there, Kahuna.
You know what? I walked in the ring with a legitimate injury to my knee, and Curtis Youngbear kicked the crutch out from under me. So what was I supposed to do? I just fell down and I accidentally hit him with the crutch. Everybody saw it. You saw it. All the people at home saw it. It was an accident.
We're seeing Corino cinch on a headlock here on Robbie Royce.
Do you make believe every second of your life there, Kahuna?
It was an accident. I apologize to Curtis Youngbear for accidentally hitting him with that crutch.
That shoulder block was no accident. He powered him to the floor. Misses with a chop. Reversal. Oh! Can't give it. Oh! Quick move. Oh! One, two. Power bomb into a pinning combination there. Royce puts it.
Okay, Kahuna, you think you got the upper hand this time, but I can promise you one thing. Come the next show, you will feel like General Custer did it his last time.
A little bit of a breather there. Oh, Carino's going out of the ring.
He's not waiting. He's got to stay on top here, Royce. As I said, Royce has got the speed advantage.
Like you said earlier, you can't give anyone an inch.
Oh, big right hand. Look out,
Carino. Slamming Royce into the guardrails.
They almost came over the ring railing at us here.
Hopefully the fans move their apples.
Carino's got the horn. He's got the horn. Tooting his own horn. I didn't know this was a fans bring the weapons match, Kahuna. Carino tooting his own horn there. Using those guardrails to his advantage. What's he got here?
Fly swatter.
A giant fly swatter.
This has suddenly turned into a fans bring the weapons.
Look out, Robbie. Carino sizing him up. Oh, gives him a licking. On the derriere.
Maybe there's a fly down there. Oh, there's another fly. Oh, he seems to be giving Royce a little bit of a spanking here, but that's not going to get him the title. You got to pin him 1, 2, 3 if you want to get the title.
That's a complete lack of respect for the CWF champion on behalf of Carino. Giving him a licking in front of his own hometown fans. Royce jumping on top of him on his re-entry into the ring. He stays on top of him.
Now Royce with the upper hand.
Royce falls Carino to the floor.
One thing you gotta remember is Robbie Royce can take it to the top rope, he can take it to the bottom rope.
Yeah.
Oh, Carino flying into the fans.
That was unexpected.
Right into the front row.
He knocked out about 5 or 6 fans there.
Did you see that?
Somebody get some ambulance staff over that way. Make sure the fans are all
right. Right into the front row, Steve Carino.
Fans are on their feet. Carino and Royce duking it out in the audience.
They're taking it out into the audience here. Once again, we're having a hard time seeing from our side where they are.
There is a camera there, but we're not getting any footage.
They're fighting in the middle of a mob.
I fear for the safety of anybody around those
two men. Are
they
going to be going up to that balcony again?
No, not again. Like two giant elks battling it out in Banff National Park. Anybody in the way is going to get run over.
These great competitors battling it out in the middle of the vans.
We got no footage over that way. We can't see. We got no camera feed. Be careful up there, Kuna.
Yeah, your knee might give out. Eh?
Your knee might give out there, Kuna. Heaven forbid. All we can hear is the impact of those shots getting exchanged by both men.
Are they going to be going up to that balcony again?
They're going to have to put cages up on the stairs there next show out here, Kuna.
Unparalleled action, folks.
Unparalleled.
We'll never see this anywhere.
Royce
in
is
the
starting
world, except right here.
Oh, somebody got hit. I seen a beverage get splashed around there back. Both men, we can't see nothing. They're swallowed up in a sea of humanity. A sea of humanity has swallowed these two competitors.
These gladiators giving it all, folks. Here,
look
out!
As you can see by the movement of the fans.
They're going from corner of the building to another corner. And then we got a shot of Steve Carino there and Robbie Royce. Where are they going? They're going into the bathroom or something back there.
There's Carino. He's bringing Royce to the corner of the building near the bar area.
Oh, right into the house. It looks like he threw him into the door. They could be going outside in the parking lot.
Are they going outside here? Fans.
Where are they going?
Really? Waitress was rather lovely there. We'll call some kind of action. We can't see anything. Men have made their way to the outside area.
They could very well take this fight out into the streets of St. Boniface.
Right into the cement wall. I saw that.
I saw that one. Carino throwing Royce into the cement wall.
We all saw that one.
Carino! Carino!
Referee Kenny Rogers put the two count on him. Royce happened to kick out for some time.
Carino! Bust the mullet open!
Fans are getting their money's worth here.
Oh, looked like a low blow.
Yep.
A shot to the groin there by Robbie Royce. Staggering back to his feet.
Yeah! Oh, it's coming back!
Carino got head first into the bar.
This has turned into a barroom brawl over in the corner.
You want an ECW rules, you're getting it.
That's right, I ordered an ECW rules here.
Royce has got the upper hand here. I got a glimpse of him. Oh, he just took a sip and then splashes into Carino's face.
We've been just told that Robbie is kicking the living creations out of him.
We've got fans coming up to their area here, giving us the play-by-play as we go along. Both men making their way. Carino limping his way to the ringside area.
I hope they're not going to head over here. They got too much equipment over
here. Like we said, folks, they're taking this fight to all four corners of this building.
Carino's got the upper hand here. Into the cement wall.
They're going to throw him into the cement wall.
What are we going to see here? Reversal.
Reversal into the ladder, bro.
Into the ladder.
Right into the ladder.
Royce. Beautiful. Desperation reversal into the ladder.
He's going to go for the pin.
Counted. One. Two.
Oh,
two
count. Just in time.
Carino digging deep.
Kicked out just in time.
We're surrounded here by a sea of humanity.
Oh, now where are they going?
Oh, into the cement wall.
Oh, into the wall. Pole.
Into that.
Yeah, boy, Showtime.
Robbie Royce.
Into that cement pillar.
Royce going for
one,
quick pin.
Two. Hooks the leg. Carino
kicks out again.
Slow count by Kenny Rogers. Come faster. Come faster.
That's right. Tell me.
Oh.
Face full of.
Savant
kick. In the chin by Steve Carino.
Did you see the torque on that Savant kick?
Oh my God.
His head almost came off his shoulders. Look out.
Oh, they're all over the place here. They're
stay
all
away
over.
From the monitors.
Oh, oh no. They're heading back. Thank God they're heading back to the ring area.
Royce into the stage. I don't think he's going to give a concert here. Whoa.
These men look exhausted. They look like they've dropped 5 pounds since the start of the match. They're giving it their all.
One of these guys are going to lose a match here tonight. You can be dropping a lot more than 5 pounds if you're dropping the heavyweight title. Suplex up in the air. Snap suplex down onto the mat.
Carino still has him.
Still got it locked on. Another one. We see a three count here.
Carino yet again.
Holds him up for a 3-1-2-3. Oh,
what let that blood rush into?
Suplex. That took a lot out of Carino too. He seems to be a little bit worse for wear from that one.
What goes up must come down.
The blood rushing into Royce's head while being suspended in midair. And a kick out by Royce in the nick
of time. That's a lot of weight to put on one knee. Still favoring that knee a little bit. If Royce can gain his senses, I get back on that leg and keep him on the ground.
Gingerly back to their feet. Knife edge chop. The sternum area is just beat red. Right hand chops.
Both men on the chest.
Oh,
the time the
right to the chops. Talk about a chop that was right to the chops.
Royce beating him on left leg.
He's going up for the elbow. This could be all she wrote, Daddy-O.
Takes time to adjust his knee pad. That could be enough time for Carino to get to his feet.
Royce. Perhaps wasting a little too much time.
He wasted too much time. Carino falls across the rope. Whether that was desperation or an accident, or just smart. I took Robbie Royce right off his feet.
Now Royce, seeing stars on the top rope.
Calling for a superplex.
That's right, he's got him set up for a superplex. Let's see if he can pull it off. Cowboy Bob Orton made this move famous.
The fans Royce. Want to see it.
Cowboy Bob Orton was the master of the superplex.
Carino taking a page out of his scrapbook. Royce blocking it. Hammering Carino. Both men exchanging shots up on that second rope. Royce shoving Carino off.
So drop it. So drop it.
And now Royce back to the other top rope.
Oh! Carino
nailing
him.
Carino nailing Royce off the top rope into the gut.
Putting that right hand into the bread basket of Royce as he came down off the top rope.
What a match we've seen so far. NWA North American title on the line. CWF title on the line. These two men are fighting tooth and nail. Unbelievable.
This is quite a follow-up to the CWF TLC match that we just saw a little while ago. Oh, big power slam. One, two, two count on Royce. And a near pinfall once again, and Robbie Royce with another kick out. About the 20th near pinfall we've had in this match already. There it is, a slap drop. Right in the middle of the ring. How much more can these superstars take?
I don't know. I'm getting sore just watching them.
I think we better call up the Red Cross for some blood transfusions. Royce is calling for the savant kick. Nobody owns Dick on Kenny Rogers.
He hit cap referee Kenny Rogers there somehow.
Get another referee out of the back. He didn't know how to count this one, I don't think. Wait a second. He locks it in.
Oh, this ain't right.
Garuna showing his true colors, tucking his tail between his legs and hiding behind a woman. What kind of man are you, Guna? Manhandling our production assistant, Sandra. Royce. The Irish whip reversal. Carino into the ladder. That might
thrown into the corner, into the ladder.
Royce setting up that ladder now. Pardon me, setting up the table. But he reversed Carino into that ladder. And now both men are Carino trying, struggling to get some steam here.
Trying to pull himself together, trying to collect his marbles. Well, Royce seems to be doing a little repair to that table.
Kenny Rogers is on the outside trying to collect his marbles. Referee Kenny Rogers. DDT by Royce.
And the light could be all over. Royce is setting up that table.
He's keeping Carino off his feet.
Carino taking another pound into the head.
What are we gonna see here from Royce as he sets that table up into the corner?
Robbie Royce setting up the table in the corner.
Oh, mule kick!
We're gonna Carino picking up Royce, pile driver!
Pile driver, Robbie Royce, cover! Kick out!
And another near pinfall! How close can you get? And how many times?
Both referees seem with a slow count. Whoa, language.
What was
language
that?
Language is a family show, Carino. He can't be a... Oh, back body. Oh! Put Carino that cracked that table.
Robbie Royce reversing.
Well, Royce got to get on the count.
That's right.
I can't take this. I got to get closer to the action.
What about your knee?
One, two, three. Uh-oh. Kahuna's going to the bathroom once again, folks. How many trips to the bathroom did he need to take?
Maybe he had too many apple juices in the back.
Could be.
Royce and Dalton.
Exchanging closed fists.
Pardon me, Royce and Carino exchanging fists. Carino going downstairs, working the breadbasket.
Carino sizing.
Bionic elbow! The bionic elbow. Oh, headbutt to the groin. Desperation move. Guna's fed up. He doesn't know what to make of it.
Carino taking it to the CWF champion now.
Two counts.
And Royce with another kick out.
Both men are giving it all here, our man. ECW rules anything goes, and anything is going here.
You can cut the tension in the air tonight, folks.
This atmosphere, this place is absolutely on fire.
Carino bionic elbow once again.
The pin. One, two. Oh, Royce.
Another kick out.
The heart. That's why he's the king of the mountain here in the CWF, our man.
For obvious reasons.
You want to talk about King? Yeah, talk about old school. There you go.
Carino reversing his elbows.
Whoa. Now Royce with his own elbows.
Royce reversing it out of his own way.
Doc on your own. Another referee goes down. We're running out of referees here tonight. Anybody in here know how to count to three?
I think we might be fine.
We might be hard pressed. Another CWF fan. Whoa. Schoolboy.
Small package.
Cooking the tights. No, he couldn't get it. One, two. Kenny Rogers is in there.
Roy's getting out of that cradle.
Oh, Kahuna.
Kahuna nailing him with the belt. There you have it. The Bronx cheers.
That dirty snake in the grass.
Once again, Team Impact. The leader of Team Impact getting involved here.
Two.
Three count.
And you have it, folks.
We got a new NWA champion. A double champion, Robbie Royce.
Robbie Royce.
They fought tooth and nail, and in the end, Big Kahuna, the leader of Team Impact,
just defeated Steve Corino.
How can you call this an upset? There's
with
no upset here. Kahuna sticking
his
nose
buddy,
in it again.
The Big Kahuna.
What a travesty, folks. A complete travesty here.
We won't be able to stand for this.
The Kahuna nailing Carino with that belt.
Isn't this great, you guys? Isn't it great to see a new NWA North America champion here?
What are you talking about?
Great.
Carino was robbed.
It was miraculous, just like Kahuna's knee injury. A miraculous comeback.
You guys got to realize,
Big Kahuna,
he makes them and he breaks them. And it doesn't matter if you're from ECW, WCW, or WWF. When you come to the CWF, Ernie Todd,
you watch your back. You come to the CWF, you watch your backs for guys like Ernie Todd, aka the Big Kahuna.
So what'd you girls think of the match?
Lots of blood.
Lots of blood. Did you enjoy yourself?
Yeah.
Oh, you bet I did. I think we all enjoyed the match.
Hold on. Robin was feeling
my arse.
Yeah. TCW, that? Yeah.
That was some crazy.
Absolutely amazing. Amazing.
You guys enjoy the match?
Yeah, sure did.
Wow! CWF and APTN, a winning combination.
That was the greatest show I've ever.
It was awesome.
Awesome show.
Yeah.
Lots of blood.
Pretty hardcore.
First time to wrestling, the kids dragged me along, and now I'm hooked.
Thought of the show, visit our website at cwfwrestling.com or call 988-4986. That's 988-4986. Thanks for tuning in. Catch you next time. Bye-bye.